Hi, I'm Matt.
And this is my dad, Emeritus Professor Charles Griffiths. He's an expert in marine biology and has found a ton of new species. And together, we're going to explore the shore. Welcome to the shore. Let's see what we can find.
So are these guys also limpets?
So this is a different species of limpet, the granular limpet. It's one of the dominant species in the middle intertidal. And these limpets don't have gardens, so these are more like cattle, and this is their field. And we're obviously seeing them when they're inactive here now, when the tide is out. They're just clamp down onto the rock. They're very firmly attached here, very difficult to get off. This is their sleep time. But when the tide comes in, these guys will get up and then they'll move around all across this rock surface, grazing the little microscopic algae. These are tiny algae actually on the rock, these little black and red patches on the rock. And that's what keeps these rocks completely clear of seaweeds. So if you remove these limpets, then within a couple of weeks, this whole rock surface would become completely covered by seaweeds. Or you can draw a circle of antifouling paint on the rock to keep them off. Then within a couple of weeks, then the rocks will become completely covered in seaweeds.
So it's like they're mowing the lawn.
They're mowing the lawn, exactly, yeah. Very effectively, keeping it completely clean. You can see here how the only algae that's growing on the rocks is growing on the backs of limpets. So that's the only place the limpets can't get at it. So here we've got a limpet, here we've got another limpet, and the rest of the rock is basically kept perfectly clean by the grazing activities of these cattle out on this field. And yeah, there you see it's actually a limpet with its big sticky foot. Yeah, and here's his head with the tentacles. Quite a cute little guy. Wondering what on earth has happened. His world has turned upside down. So this is his big adhesive foot. And then in this little channel here are the animal's gills. And then this outer bit of flesh here, which is called the mantle, is what actually secretes and makes the shell. What you see on his back, stacks of seaweed. And that's the only seaweed around.
So I'm just looking across the rock and seeing all these little tufts of seaweed now. So that means each one of those is a little limpet underneath.
So these are the invasive European mussel, the Mediterranean mussel, that was introduced to South Africa in about 1979 and has now occupied a lot of the space that was previously occupied by the little granular limpets. And we thought that would be a huge problem for the granular limpets and then would outcompete them. But what has in fact happened is the granular limpets are starting to live on the surface of an individual mussel shell. So if you look at these mussels here, you can see there's a limpet on the side of each mussel. And that's its territory. And it actually grows there and spends its whole life on that bulb of the mussel shell. So it can't grow very big, so they in fact become kind of bonsai'd, but they can occur at an enormous density because the surface area on a rock covered in mussels is much greater than the surface area of the rock on its own.
Whoop, wave.
Here comes a big wave. So usually when you see limpets at low tide and you usually go to the shore during the day, they're just inactive and stuck down onto the rocks. But if you look in a shady area like this, particularly in the winter when it's not too hot, then you can actually see them walking around. So here's one it's got his tentacles out and he's actually wandering around.